Hello again. Mr. Vasquez, and I'm here to finish the last video because I'm sorry I didn't know. Now I notice that we have only 10 minutes, less than 10 minutes to finish all the videos because in this new program that my sister and my daughter Denise and my sister gave me because it's a I love it. It's better than the other one for the first two videos, but in this I can use like the whiteboard. So let me go directly to the second, to the letter F problem, because I need to teach you how to solve this step by step. You will love this with knowing what are all those missing steps that most of the teachers don't consider when they solve a problem. Okay, so let me prepare this. And for us to be concentrated on the okay, next page. Okay, here I already solved it, but I cannot erase it anymore because it's already solved in PowerPoint. So let me explain step by step. We have all the steps, and let's do this quicker because we need to finish in less than 10 minutes, remember, for this new kind of videos. But it's enough, it's enough time for solving all the two problems that I will present to you in all my videos. Okay, so in letter F, what do we have? We have A minus 2 times, because it's a big bracket, 3 minus 4 times, we have another multiplication, square root of 50 minus 14 and separator plus 5, close the bracket. So the multiplication ends when we close the bracket, but we have inside the bracket another parenthesis. The square root, it's a parenthesis. That's the reason I use in the second step. Check the second step, and it's marked with a pink, I'm sorry, yellow color, because it's very important for you to know what is the missing step here. The missing step, most of the teachers, they never will tell you, is that the square root is like if we have a parenthesis that is raised to an exponent. And what is the exponent? Is 1/2. So the square root is an exponent, but it's a fraction. That's the reason I put the definition that is to the right, that is circled also in yellow color. If we have square root of x equals x raised to the 1/2 power, okay? We are going to use that in the future in all our problems with algebra, advanced, not advanced algebra, but the other problems when we need to use variables and expressions with lots of terms that contain variables and numbers, fractions and whole numbers or decimals, but this is very, very important for knowing that a square root or any root, cubic root, four root, it is an exponent, but it's a fractional exponent. So it is like we have a parenthesis raised. The other reason is color in yellow for you to have this. But let's go back using the square root, because it's easier for us in this kind of programs. Okay, the third, let's concentrate on the third step. So we have A minus 2 times, 3 minus 4 times, again, square root of 36 plus 5, we close the bracket. What is the next step? Solving the exponent, because now you know, because the thing that I told you about the square root, the parenthesis that is inside the bracket. So the square root is the first thing that we need to solve. And what is the number? It is a real number, because we have a number that multiplied by itself equals 36. 6, 6 times 6 equals 36. And that's the reason we are going to put the 6 but inside a parenthesis. Why inside a parenthesis? Because if we have another operation surrounding more than one operation, or only at least one operation surrounding the square root, we need to use a parenthesis for avoiding confusing with the other operation. Now, We already saw that step in the other videos. So a minus 2 times 3 minus 4 times 6 plus 5, what is the next step? Inside the bracket we need to go solving the multiplication. The multiplication is first and finally the addition and subtraction. And for multiply, what we need to do first is multiplying the signs. Negative times positive is negative. So that's the reason we keep everything exactly the same. We need to work, remember, vertically always, and you will never fail solving the algebra problems. A minus 2 times 3 minus 24, because 4 times 6 is 24, plus 5. And now, we have the case inside the bracket that we have two operations that are solved at the same time. Remember I told you in the other videos. If we have a subtraction and an addition, we work always from left to right. From left to right. Okay? So, first we need to do the subtraction. And how can we subtract 3 minus 24? Our little frog, remember, for adding and subtracting, the little frog goes first to the right 3 times, but then it goes back 24 times to the left. So what number do we get? Is minus 21. So your kids, your children will love this idea of the little frog for addition and subtraction. It's easy. Why? I don't know why the rest of the teachers use this for teaching you easily math. Okay, minus 21 plus 5. And then minus 21 plus now, we begin again from 0, and then the little frog is going to go where? To the left 21 times, and it will go back 5 times, so that's the reason the answer is minus 16. Minus 16 inside the, because remember, we can chase now the bracket for a parenthesis because we don't have more other parentheses. And now the next step is multiplication. Negative times negative is positive, and 2 times 16, 32. And finally, our little frog and begin to go to the right 8 times to the right, and then 32 more times to the right. Our little frog finally arrives to 40 positive 4. Did you like this? It's amazing. Yes or no? Let me switch a little bit into Spanish for explaining you a little bit in Spanish. ¿Qué les parece, muchachos, muchachas, amigos, amigas? Esto es emocionante. A mí me emociona mucho cómo podemos resolver cualquier problema de álgebra, trigonometría, cálculo, lo que sea, de matemáticas de manera fácil. A ver, rápido el inciso E. A ver si tengo tiempo de hacerlo en español todo. 6 más 4 al cuadrado dividido todo entre 3 al cuadrado por 4. Pues primero se hace separado. Nuestro formato o machote es el numerador entre el denominador. El numerador sería 6 más 16, porque primero se hace el exponente. Y abajo también, primero el exponente 9 por 4. Segundo paso, la ranita. 6 a la derecha y 16 a la derecha, 22. Sobre 9 por 4, positivo por positivo, 9 por 4, 36 positivo. Siempre se aplica lo que está ahí escrito arriba. Entonces tengo 22, 36 avos, pero esa no es la respuesta. Si la pone, se la pueden poner mal. Así es que simplifiquenla, se puede dividir entre 2. 22 entre 2 y 36 entre 2. Si no se pueden los dos, numerador y denominador, entre el mismo número, no lo hace. Hasta que sea 1. ¿Sí? Entonces la respuesta final es 11, 18 avos. Entre 18, porque el 11 es un número primo, nada más se puede dividir entre 11 o entre 1. Rápidamente el F. ¿Qué les decía? Del primero al segundo paso, esto es maravilloso, porque aquí está ese famoso missing step que los maestros nunca hablan. La raíz cuadrada es como un paréntesis, poniendo lo que está dentro de la raíz elevado a la primera. Si fuera raíz cúbica, a la 1 tercio. Si fuera raíz cuarta, a la 1 cuarto. Pero esto nada más para que sepan, en el futuro lo vamos a usar muchas veces. Pero desde ahorita sus hijos, sus niños lo van a necesitar. Por esto es mi Mad Moms. Soñado por siempre. Ok, tercer paso. Volvemos otra vez a la raíz porque es más fácil. 50 menos 14 es 36. ¿Y qué número multiplicado por sí mismo nos da 36? Es 6. Y luego dentro del corchete, primero que va, multiplicación. Entonces menos por más menos, 6 por 4, 24. Y luego aquí se repite eso que les decía, que tenemos dos operaciones que se resuelven al mismo tiempo. 3 menos 24 más 5 es primero la que está a la izquierda y luego la que está a la derecha. Si no, nos puede salir diferente. Entonces, esta es una